Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. Today it's a day that I'm back to YouTube. I'm back to making videos. I'm back to making commentaries about videos. I've edited quite a lot of videos. I was in the mood to actually edit some videos, you know. There was no problem about that. Editing something like 7-6 videos, but I took some time, clear a bit my mind. And yeah, I'm gonna upload this video, probably another one, and then we're gonna make an informing video in which I'm gonna be talking to you about some serious things, including probably a change at the name of the channel, and probably something new in the channel. Don't worry, it's still gonna be F1 and FIFA, but something like we're just gonna get probably added. It depends on you, basically, but you're gonna see everything. The informing video, so don't forget to check it out. It's gonna be a very important video for me, probably the most important informing video that I'm ever gonna make on this channel. But you saw that we're here in Spain, one of my favorite tracks of the entire F1 calendar. So we're here in Spain, we're just already on the practice station. But before we actually start commentating that practice station, you saw that all my upgrades are coming. He just came at the best point for this race. It's one of my favorite races, one of the best races for the AI. The AI seems to go really fast on this track, so gotta watch out for that. So do not expect to win. Lost a bit the front of the car right here, pretty strange to see that, but we couldn't get that all purple. We go up a green just at the end of this third sector, but onto the tire. I don't even remember how we call it. I haven't played it for quite a long time, F1, but these videos are pre-recorded yesterday, you know. I must have recorded those videos back in November or December, so I can still finish that season 2 very, very easily, just to let you know. So we're into the time management test. We got 2 reds, then we got 2 greens, 3 greens as you can possibly see, and yeah, pretty much we're just doing the business right now. And we need to get some purpose in order to get our purple score, as we can possibly see right here. Going out around the final corner, we already got a purple. So if we get this purple right here, I think we can just complete this test possibly. Okay, we got it, we got the completed one, not the purple result. Got the green result, but now onto the qualifying pace test. I knew this test was going to be very hard, but I just couldn't do anything. Like 1.5 seconds slower right here onto the first lap. Then we gone straight onto the second lap. As you can see there, it was really, really fast in the first and second sector. Like in the second sector, we were just some thousands of a second slower than the target lap time. And then, right here, just lose like seconds on the third sector. So I lost 5 tenths throughout just 2 corner, so that's really strange to see. I don't even know what I'm doing wrong. I can't go that much faster. Like, I've boosted and boosted and boosted, just something didn't really work with me and the car. We just, like, I lost 1 second to the third second. There you have it. It is improved, but indeed, like, look at this. Now I just gave it out like 5 seconds. Just gave it out. I was really frustrated about that. But there you go, you can see that. We were pretty frustrated not to get some more resource points in order to develop the car and fight the Red Bulls. But there you have it, perfect track optimization test. Time management test was completed and failed in the qualifying paces. So let's go into real qualifying and hope we can do well. So here we are, onto the qualifying session. As you can possibly see, this is my final attempt, my final and best attempt. We currently sat in P20. It didn't really go well. But I hope I can get an improved lap. Like, Verstappen is leading, of course. I don't know where I'm losing time. As you clearly see, we are good. First sector just 1/10 slower than Verstappen right over here. Of course, the lap is also like 2/10 improved. But go now for the second sector, as you can possibly see. We are currently 3/10, almost 3/10 faster. Now we're clearly like 6/10 faster. goes into that corner right here, going really fast right here, really smoothly. And now we're just 7 tenths, which is pretty decent as you can possibly see. Going out through the third sector, through the final corners. 1 second improvement on final lap, so this would be pretty alright. But unfortunately, we are not in pole.
Just wasn't our day.
We're in 15th place. 15th place for the Spanish Grand Prix, which is one of my
best tracks.
The grid
is all set then for the race tomorrow. But before we go, let's quickly remind ourselves of our top three, who are Verstappen, Ricardo, and Fernando Alonso. It's time to leave for now, but we'll be back tomorrow when the Grand Prix itself gets underway.
Like, this is pretty dreadful, I could say. Like, 15th place it is. My teammate Kevin Magnussen is signed P4. Let's hope that he can do something better than me, because this really isn't like the track. Like, the AI is so fast, so OP. Like, let's just go into the race, hope we can do well, have a good start, and then gotta play with the strategy a little bit in order to have a good result. Let's get into the race.
Good afternoon from a very familiar setting. It's race day here in Spain, and with everything still to play for in the championship battle, there's no room for mistakes in a Grand Prix that's well known for creating them.
Time it is for the Spanish Grand Prix. Music is on, the epic music is on. Let's call it a bit better. I don't know what is going to happen. It's all going to be criticized onto the start. You know, if you get off to a good start, then we can do the lot. Like, we're going to play a bit with the strategy. One-stop strategy we're going to go for. So a good start to get into the points, first of all. And then everything will possibly it will walk fine, I guess. Like, that's my ideology right here. But it's 5 red lights and it's lights outer than where we go for the Spanish Grand Prix. We get off already to a better start than the Haas right on my side by Romain Grosjean. We've got the 2 forces just right ahead, and then we have the Williams. So gonna go down the inside. We get 3 cars into turn 1. That's really good to see. And Massa just goes straight into us.
A big one.
And us put us off the race. Well, oh my. No, that is just. This is just, nah, mate, look at this. Look at this, mate. Who did push Massa? Massa just going straight onto me. That's the old board of Massa. That's Lewis Hamilton. Of course. Who else would be? Oh my god. Just bumped into his wheel. There I go. Straight. Massa goes straight off to my tire. And somehow, like, I know, like, the damage model is not that good in this game, but somehow, we just broke. Like, you can crash into a wall, nothing will happen. But now Massa just goes with not so much speed. He just goes straight onto me, and my wheel is off. Like, nah, mate. Massa's race isn't even over. Like, you can see my team, and they had a dreadful start. But absolutely dreadful. Well, it wasn't a good weekend from beginning of the race, I've got to say. But
for the Red Bull team today.
But in all honesty, I would love to get some points in this race,
well,
but
track conditions just really
apparently
today.
It's track temperature, you name it wasn't it. To happen,
these
you know. Also, I can't see my team on the podium.
Right,
that's more about
so
to see the team
there,
actually
the
didn't get a podium.
Exactly,
well, Sebastian Vettel ended up in 6th place. Ferrari also not having a good season at all. Verstappen's won the race. The 2 Red Bulls are 1-2. They just have the better car. Like, we can do anything rather than just developing our car more and more and more in order to catch up with those guys. Also, McLaren, who have an amazing car. Not actually the second fastest car. We are the second fastest car, but they just seem so fast. I don't know what it is. Is it the drivers? Is it something like, I don't know, I just don't know. Fernando Alonso to P3, well, pretty good race.
And now let's take a look at the driver standings.
Oh.
It's a good result for Max Verstappen, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Well, my driver of the day was Nico Hülkenberg. He did a cracking job moving through the field and just highlighting why he's so highly rated in the paddock.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Red Bull have extended their lead over the championship. There was also a strong showing from the McLaren team today as they make their way up the standings. There'll be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you can join us at the next race to see just who will come out on top.
So, as you can possibly see, my team is just couldn't get through. Like, we're pretty close. Like, Kevin was 2 seconds behind Alonso and 4 seconds behind Ricciardo. So, he's just, he's gonna get the podium. But again, the podium, like, it would be really useful to have Kevin on the podium. He got some positions with a fourth place. Still good, but not good enough. He's into P11, and, like, in contrast to me, he's not very good. But, what can we say, like, we're now third in the constructors, we're still third, but McLaren have just passed Mercedes and they are fourth, so yeah.
I've got something you'll be interested in. Those performance upgrades we discussed after the last race, they're on the car and the data looks promising. Take a look at the details.
So yeah, as I told you, we're third, but McLaren are very, very close to us in order to overtake us, so it's looking very close between me and Renault. With Renault and McLaren, so they could really overtake us very easily, but gotta wait about those things. It's still gonna be pretty complicated, you know, but we don't really know what is gonna happen. But we're here in Monaco, new upgrades on the car, it's a new drug upgrade I put on the car, and now we are officially the second fastest car on the field. So let's put some pressure, because for the moment we are the ones who can actually contend with the Red Bull. So Monaco, well, we all know I hate it. We all know I just hate Monaco. Last season we retired already. I have damage on the front wing. We still got the purple, it's the third lap, but we got it. Yes, that's what matters. Maximum resource points for that test. Oh my god, just punking into the walls. I don't know what it's going on. Okay, time has been tested. Is okay, side out with a green. That's pretty encouraging to see, because I don't have good memory. The only good memory I have is from F1 2015, where I won with in the Nico Hülkenberg green mode. We have overtaken Vettel in the final laps. He was one of my favorite videos to make and one of my favorite races to drive out. But yeah, as you can possibly see, we are actually doing very well in the tire management test. So, got some purples, got two greens. We actually achieved the purple score, so it's actually a very, very good sign of things to start off. Like in Spain, we got the green, the completed sign for the tire management test, but in this one, got a purple, we got some great laps, and we actually got the purple results, so perfect result on the time management test. Then went on to do the qualifying pace. It was a moment like I said, no, we're not gonna make this, but apparently we were doing absolutely amazingly. I don't know what it was going on. I practiced quite a lot in Monaco. I said this time I'm gonna finish this race. We also get some traffic during this session, so we had some traffic, and we still actually made it out of the final corner very nicely. And we still actually got an amazing result, amazing lap. We got third projected time for that session. We've done a bit of a mistake there, but instead we might even have traffic. But oh my god, Ryo just backed the car into the inside wall. But you know, we have achieved what we wanted to do. We got perfect score onto the qualifying paces. So what else? Like perfect practice session. We got a perfect result at every single test. Like amazing results. Track calendarization test was perfect. Time management test was perfect. And the most exciting qualifying pace test was perfect. We got third projected position. So absolutely amazing. So get back into the paddock. We've got a new rival.
Looks like you've got a bit of rivalry going on out there. This is good. Gets people talking about you. Just make sure you outperform them, okay?
So now we have a new rival. coming out, and it's my boy Kimi Raikkonen, probably my favorite driver onto the grid at the moment, you know, and from back into the years, but he's going to qualifying and try and do the job like we didn't practice. Already into qualifying, we're here, it is a bit cloudy, so I was scared about the weather. No, I remember, I don't know which game I was, I believe it was in the 15 where I just went out while all the others had done laps on the slick tires. I went out with the slick tires and it was raining, and then up in P20, I don't remember. But this is probably my best lap here around Monaco, and we currently start in P2, we've done a very, very good job already with the first lap. I'm kind of going to try, you know, take that pole position for Max Verstappen. We're still slowing into the first sector, but faster than our fastest personal lap. I hope we can get the pole position. It would be amazing after the drag upgrade and also into one of my worst tracks in the Italian calendar to get that pole position. But as you can see, my driving is not actually that bad around this track, so it wasn't really that bad, and we actually got pole position into the Monaco Grand Prix, provisional pole position. I was like, should I give up? And they said, let's give up. Let's give up this lap. I don't think I can improve any more. My tires were already dead. So that's through Fernando Alonso, who's in P3. Really excited to see Fernando doing some really good business. So I was already celebrating the pole position here. I was so happy to get pole position, but apparently it is P2. Well, that was devastating.
The grid is all set then for the race tomorrow. But before we go, let's quickly remind ourselves of our top three, who are Verstappen, Renault, and Jenson Button. It's time to leave for now, but we'll be back tomorrow when the Grand Prix itself gets underway.
So as I thought and celebrating about the pole position, it was provisional, but I was sure I would get it. But apparently, also Ricciardo got disqualified. Huge chance right here to win this race, but we lost pole. Absolutely dreadful. I know it is good to get P2. Let's just go into a race and hope we can do well. Here we are on the grid of the Monaco Grand Prix, starting off with P2, on the side is the big tits. Why did I say big tits? Well, I should edit that, but we're in P2, starting off on our right is Max Verstappen, who got pole position. The strategy is pretty simple, we're going to start on the ultra soft and then go onto the super soft. As you can see, I had a terrible get off, go away, get off, like, into the formation lap, so that was pretty, like, I was like, oh my god, let's just don't have that start in for the start of this race. But as I talk about start, he slides down, and away we go, Verstappen gets off to a bad start, and we actually got him already from into the straight line, into the launching. We had better launching than Verstappen, so there was no need to get him into turn 1, we got him very, very easily. We're into P1, I see some yellow flags right on the back. You see my teammate right here. It's not really good to see, but already got into P1. Button. Jenson Button is in P3. Really good to see the McLaren and personally, I really like James Sabata, so really good to see him into P3. And yeah, we're just gonna lead the way, try and get away from Verstappen. I know he's not got a lot of chances to overtake me, probably around after the tunnel, probably it will be his only chance. And also into the start finish straight, but I saw I had good pace into practice. Let's put it into use for the race, and yeah, just hope we can get away from Verstappen very easily. Lap 15 it is, and as you can see, if you see me editing so big parts of this of the race, then you can understand that it's because it's a boring race. Like, I've been leading for so long, it's time for my pit stop. I've got quite a lot of tire wear onto my tires, and it's like a bit of an undercar. It's very, very weird to see like Verstappen staying an extra lap while he's 6 or 7 seconds behind. We get a bit held on by Jensen died here, but no problem about that. But it's pretty strange to see Verstappen, because he's got no chance of like exiting the pistons ahead of me after that strategy of him, after the decision I just made. But exiting the pistons into P3 right ahead of us is Sergio Perez, and then I think it's Verstappen leading the way, but I'm gonna be back into the lead very soon, I guess. And there you go, as we set the fastest lap onto that set of super soft tires. Verstappen. Oh, safety car. Well, Verstappen. Stop, Jeff. I need to stop talking. I know, mate. I know. Alright, virtual safety car is zedding. Shut up, Jeff. Shut up. Thank you a lot. We're into P1, and Verstappen is a long way behind. As you can see, that virtual safety car helped me quite a lot, because I could just control the gap. But Verstappen is 1.4 seconds behind me. Oh, Lord. Did you see that? Did you see how close I went to the wall? Just look at it. Oh, my God. I think I touched the wall. Thank God, no damage. I've been pushing quite a lot. I really enjoyed. Oh, my Lord. There's a pileup right here. Oh, Jesus. Please don't make me have any damage. Thank you a lot, safety car. Of course, safety car. It should have been deployed earlier. I could have lost a template. There was a chance I could have lost a template right here. Also, my tire is in really bad condition, so thank God that safety car came in and used a lot of my wheel on that tire, on those tires. So the car behind us is not going to attack us. I think it is Nico Rosberg. He's actually a lap car, so don't worry about him at the moment. So we're still doing very well. Do not worry about anything like this. The final lap, nothing's gonna happen. Do not. Oh, goddamn it! Well, we had some wheel on the engine. That's why we lost quite a lot of time to Verstappen, as you can possibly see on the final lap. So I felt the car a little bit slower through that final laps, but do not worry about it. It's the last sector, final sector, final corners. It's gonna be my second win in Monaco ever in my entire Formula 1 career, in every single game. Absolutely insane to celebrate this win. Another win in Monaco in a track that I didn't expect to win. I just didn't expect that. Like, absolutely amazing job from the team, you know, from the car. I really enjoy driving around this sector, I gotta admit. Absolutely insane win. Get in, lads.
Let's take a look at the driver's standings. It's a good result for Max Verstappen, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Well, my driver of the day was Nico Hülkenberg. He did a cracking job moving through the field and just highlighting why he's so highly rated in the paddock.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. It was a tough race for our championship leaders, who lose ground at the top of the table. Meanwhile, Renault move up the table with another strong performance this weekend. There'll be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you can join us at the next race to see just who will come out on top.
Well, I've got to say, that's not like good job for Renault, that's good job for me. No sign of points for Kevin Magnussen. Really, really buzz here, because he started from PA. He had a great chance to win some points, but probably he just couldn't. We hurry on to overtook him, but win for us here in Monaco. I can't believe that we're going to win. I can't believe it. It's just unbelievable that we're going to win in Monaco. We are now got up into second after Daniel Ricciardo not getting any points into the Monaco for the Monaco Grand Prix. Like, we're now some points ahead of him and 20 points behind Max Verstappen, if I'm correct. Also, my teammate just dropped down into P13. That's really sad to see from Kevin. Not doing exactly how I want him to do, but on the construction, we overtook Ferrari and we're second. Oh, that's exciting to see, but that was it for today, guys. If you enjoyed, smash the like button. If you haven't subscribed, subscribe, follow me on Twitter and Instagram. And yeah, the next video, guys. I'll see you next time. Goodbye, lads.